Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Hey everybody, this is Reid. Today I'm going to be playing Jund in a four-round Modern Daily event. Now, at the recent Magic Online Championships, we saw Modern being played for the highest stakes that it's been played since Pro Tour Fate Reforged. And the information we got from that tournament was quite extreme and, at least for me, quite unexpected. Two different collected company decks broke out and had great success. The finals, both players were playing their take on Collected Company. Now, what that means for us black-green players is that I think Abzan's time in the sun is over. Abzan, going back to the history of the modern format, Abzan was not a top choice for many, many years because it struggled so much against Birthing Pod. Path to Exile being a bit of a liability in that those creature combo decks can make use of their extra mana, and all of the removal in black and green is a little too slow. The creatures in black and green, they're basically just big dumb bodies that attack on the ground. They really can't do enough to control the game and keep these creature combo decks from achieving their critical mass. However, Jund has a lot of tools that Abzan does not have. So I think from this point on, at least for the immediate future, Jund is going to be the deck of choice for black-green players. So to be a little more specific about what I mean, Lightning Bolt as a one-mana just no questions asked removal spell is super important against these Noble Hierarch, Birds of Paradise, Elvish Mystic decks. Then you also have access to more burn spells, whatever you might pick. I have two Kolaghan's commands here. Then you have cards like Huntmaster of the Fells, Grim Lavamancer, Olivia Voldaren, perhaps Chandra Pyromaster, that they ping creatures and they're, you know, your bread and butter creatures, but they also give you some amount of control over the game and ability to keep your opponent off of their combos, off of their critical mass. You also have access to Anger of the Gods, although I'm trying for today just one Bonfire of the Damned as my experimental card. But beyond that, I still tried to make my deck well-rounded with some good game against Burn and Delver and all the strategies that are tried and true and have been around for a long time. So, I guess the event is about to start, and we'll see how Jun treats me today. So this hand has no green mana, but it's excellent. Turn one, Inquisition, turn two, Dark Confidant. It's just exactly what you want. I guess I should also name Kolaghan's Command as a bit of an experimental card. It does seem like it has a home in Jund. It has an effect that you really want, and you know, grinding incremental advantage, being able to kill a creature. But I'm just not sure the exact number that I should be playing. Should it be in the sideboard? Should I play a lot of them? Should I play only one? Right now I have two in the main deck. I figure that'll give me a good taste for how it is. So it looks like I'm against a mill deck, which this deck is looks a little goofy, but it is better than it looks from my experience. That said, it's a good matchup for Jund. So I'm just going to take a second to write down what my opponent's got going on here, and let me read Mind Funeral. So this is basically just like, you know, mill 10 or 11 cards for 3 mana. Pretty good rate there. Given that I can't kill the Hedron Crab, that's the card I'm going to take here. Yeah, I think I want to take the crab. And then I guess I'm fine just letting my Confidant get path so that I can play the Goyf. So He'll be fine. Take Hedron Crab and see how it goes. So naturally, I don't care about my life total. I can just fire off the Dark Confidant. If I'd known Lightning Bolt was the top card of my library, I probably would have taken, you know, maybe a Mind Funeral. You need to watch out sometimes when they cast Path to Exile. They might be looking to nail you with Archive Traps, which is whenever a player searches their library or shuffles their library or something, you can cast it for free. But given that I saw my opponent's hand two turns ago, I'm not too worried about it. Okay, it looks like he doesn't care much about my Dark Confidant. I guess it's kind of like the same as the Burn matchup, right, where Confidant is effectively chipping away at my life points, but in this case, it's my library, not my life. Okay, so I was going to say that I don't really need to Inquisition this turn, but given that I have no other play I can make, I guess I might as well. Trap Maker's Snare. Huh. Let's take that Path to Exile this time. Because that, if I take the path, then the Trap Maker's Snare is going to be not super effective for my opponent. And I don't really want to take a Mind Funeral when he has two and he's missing his third land. I'll just fire off Lightning Bolt here. Perfect. Now I got to be careful about this fetch land, remember. I have my opponent on a pretty fast clock. I should be able to kill him approximately as fast as he's going to be able to Mind Funeral me. Now, I guess I might as well just play another Tarmogoyf. Just trying to think if there's any way it could possibly matter what order I do these things in. I guess I'll Thoughtseize first. Okay, so my extra discard spell is definitely coming in. Grip and Lavamancer is okay. Sometimes you kill your opponent in your own upkeep right before you're about to draw a card with no cards in your library. Fulminator Mage, I guess, could be okay. Not so excited about these removal spells. I guess I don't want a Hedron Crab to go in unanswered. Also, my opponent could have something surprising that I'm not expecting, so maybe it's worth keeping in a little bit of removal. But I think I pretty much just want to get him dead. So I'll add some creatures back. Okay, looks good. Another excellent hand. Hopefully he doesn't have three or four archive traps in his hand, because I do have to fetch on turn one. Just go straight for an overgrown tomb, I guess. Life total doesn't matter very much. Ah, Mesmeric Orb. So if we go to game three, I'll bring in some answers to that. And Jace's Phantasm. So, whenever a permanent becomes untapped, I mill one. It's 5/5. I honestly think I have to take the Jace's Phantasm here, because that, with the Glimpse of the Unthinkable, I took out many of my removal spells. I don't have Liliana in my hand. I think that's the safest move. Now, there's actually a lot of comparisons you could make between this mill deck and a burn deck. They're good at milling you for, you know, exactly 60, but they can't do so much more beyond that. And my opponent's drawn four lands already in this game, which is not great for a deck that's really going for critical mass like this. Sheldock Isle. Wow. It's kind of scary, but at least I have the Fulminators. The player has 20 or fewer. Let's go with the thoughts he's here. He has two polluted deltas and one unknown card. And I don't want to, if it is a creature somehow, it would surprise me if it was a creature, but no, I guess it just can't be a creature. So I'll duress instead. No, just three lands. Sure. Now, I do get milled for one extra card by attacking, but I have to get him down to zero life somehow. Lingering Souls. I may lose this game. What I really need to do is hit my third land to Fulminator the Sheldock Isle before it comes online. Yeah. think my play here is to cast Fulminator, and I can actually get in one attack with it, maybe. No, I should just kill it right away. No, I'll leave it in play. That's a tough question, though. Now, if my opponent casts a mill spell, I will have to Fulminator the Sheldock Isle in response. Okay, good thing I didn't sack the Fulminator Mage. Polygon's command, so that can't really do too much for me. Just going to attack with my two creatures and play another Fulminator. Oh no, that's bad for me. Yeah, I think this game I might lose, but I'm confident I'll win game three at least. So what do I need to do to have a chance here? I need to not tap for permanence. I need my opponent not to have any spell. So I think the first thing I'll do is attack with this Fulminator Mage. Yeah, I'm certain there's no way I can win this. And if I cast my Scavenging Ooze, then I will be dead, which is not good. More reasons to bring in Abrupt Decay. Now I can destroy an artifact with Kolaghan's command. But yeah, this game is over. I don't think I'll go as far as bringing in Terminate, but Ancient Grudge seems great since I'll mill it often enough. Take out some of these dumb creatures that aren't that great. Well, all of the cards here are actual good cards that I'm happy to draw, so I'm just going to submit 61. It's kind of like starting the game at 21 life, right? Okay, so no creature in this hand, but hopefully I can tear him apart with Liliana if his hand's a little slow. All right, let's take the Mesmeric Orb. Next turn I can Thought Seize and then main phase fetch just to ensure that I don't get got by archive trap. So my opponent drew Flooded Strand that turn, so let's just take away the Mind Funeral, I believe. Could take away Ensnaring Bridge. Yeah. That's probably a little bit safer, maybe. Well, yeah, I'll take the Ensnaring Bridge. No, with the Ancient Grudge in my deck, Ensnaring Bridge is very non-threatening, I think. Take the Mind Funeral. Just buys me more time. Main phase fetch. Wow, that was. I guess it's not the end of the world because now I can edict him with Liliana. I know that he did not draw Archive Trap since he drew the Hedron Crab. Definitely get rid of the crab. So my opponent's hand is Polluted Delta, Watery Grave, Path to Exile, and Ensnaring Bridge. And the Abrupt Decay was a fairly good draw for me, although I need to get a creature in play before I can really even think about attacking in the first place. Interesting. So I'm just going to discard one of my lands here, my Overgrown Tomb. Perhaps I should have killed the orb before he milled himself, just for purposes of Lingering Souls. But, I mean, in a perfect world, I would love for him to cast the Ensnaring Bridge so that I can grudge it. Okay. I'll go ahead and end of turn Abrupt Decay the Phantasm because I want to keep plussing Liliana. Man. That was not a good play because now I get milled for three. I should have grudged the orb and then untapped and Abrupt Decay the Phantasm. I was just thinking about the priority, which spell's most important to cast, not so much thinking about which spell is important to cast first. So I could see actually plussing the Liliana first. No, I guess not. Plus the Liliana first if he discards Path to Exile. That's good for me. But it's a little too fancy, I think. Maybe not. I think he will discard Path to Exile if I plus Liliana. He doesn't know I have Ancient Grudge. Let's see if I'm right. I am right. I might actually wait to decide what I'm going to Ancient Grudge. So he's declining to cast Ensnaring Bridge, which is fine by me. I'll just untap, I'll get milled for two, that's fine. Couple of good draws for me there. So I get to Thoughtseize his best card, then I get to cast Fulminator Mage and plus my Liliana. Still have Ancient Grudge in the graveyard. Sure, so let's take the Path to Exile. Attack for two, play the Fulminator plus the Liliana. And given that my opponent has no shortage of lands, I might just use the Fulminator as a beatdown card. Or wait till he plays Shaldak Isle at least. Still hasn't milled a Lingering Souls, that's fortunate for me. Yep. So now I get to Edict and Grudge the Staring Bridge, and it's just going to be a pretty clear-cut race from there. Game definitely seems more about the race than about trying to get Liliana to ultimate, so I'd rather use the Edict and then use my burn spells on my opponent. Still not going to use Fulminator Mage just yet. Still hasn't milled Lingering Souls, good for me. Okay, thankfully I have one more Edict with the Liliana. So this will put my opponent to 7, Lavamancer to 5, and then I can kill in my upkeep regardless of what happens. Question is, do I want to play this other Confidant? I think the answer is probably no. Need him to not draw Crypt Incursion. I think that's the only card that would matter here. That card matters a little bit, but sure, it's fine. He has 2 Crypt Incursions in the graveyard. No idea how many he plays. I haven't studied deck lists of this mill deck before, although I have encountered it before on Magic Online. Yep, that's not going to cut it. Remove creatures, just in case. I'll even sack this so I don't get milled anymore. That was a lot closer than I would have hoped for what I think is a good matchup. I sideboarded poorly for game 2, made a few missteps in the gameplay, but anyway, done is done, and I do advance to round 2.